In the work we've been doing for some time now, the major focus is on the environmental problem of global climate change, particularly climate change mitigation. The issue there is, how can we get big reductions in the harmful emissions that are associated with global warming while still providing the energy that we need in a reliable and affordable way? We've been focused on two major questions. One is, what are the technologies that we are able to deploy now to reduce emissions in different situations? The other major focus, what might the future look like? What is especially the role of technological innovation? So one of our objectives here then is to develop tools that many other people can use easily to ask and answer lots of different kinds of questions about the design of technology, its performance, its potential markets, and its ability to solve environmental problems. So we've developed, with support from the U.S. Department of Energy, a software environment called the Integrated Environmental Control Model. And what this is a computer application that lets analysts and researchers and technology developers look in detail at environmental control options for a single fossil fuel power plant. But we also use it in the policy world and policy analysis. Without doubt, the only way the climate problem will be addressed is with public policies that require or provide very strong economic incentives for people to install technologies that would otherwise simply not exist in the marketplace. What we've learned by studying the consequences, for example, of the Clean Air Act in the U.S. over the last 30 or 40 years is that once regulations and incentives are in place to reduce emissions, technology is not only deployed to reduce those emissions, but the natural forces of the marketplace are extremely effective in reducing the cost of those technologies and making it increasingly cheaper to reduce emissions by greater and greater amounts. Energy and environmental analysis is a key part of academic research, and it's a key part of good decision-making in government. It's not an easy area to work in. Carnegie Mellon is where we're doing it right.